Hello everyone, I hope you will be fit and fine. So I am starting NumPy. This is part of 11th and 12th too, but it is a revision of 11th class. Now I am starting with the NumPy so that your it will help in a data visualization in a class 12th. So starting with the NumPy. So here Python provides a powerful interface for a scientific computing using its popular library. See, you know that Python have a popular library from where you can import all the functions from Python library. It is being extremely used to data sciences, data analysis. So NumPy and Python Pandas are the most extensively used library supported by Python. This NumPy is a cut from your syllabus, but it is a use with the Pandas. So Pandas is another Python library. It is a software which is included in the Python library. So it is used with the both are linked together. So that's why I am teaching this chapter again and again. So that your Pandas all doubt will be clear in a data visualization. This is a very important topic. So what is NumPy? NumPy is a popular Python library. What is NumPy? It is a popular Python library used for a scientific computing. You know what is scientific computing? Any calculation, numeric calculation for scientific. NumPy and SysPy both can be used, and its acronym or numerical Python. It is called numerical Python. So it is open source module. What is it? It is a open source module of a Python which you have to import from a Python library with a pip installation, and Python that provide a function for a fast mathematical computation. By using NumPy, you can make a calculation fast on analyze and matrix. So NumPy provides excellent ND array. ND means number of 1D and 2D, number of dimensional array, and n dimensional array object. In an ND array, we can store a multiple items of a same data types. See here, I'll tell you how to install a NumPy in your system. First, you have to search from search command. You have to type a cmd. To open a command prompt, you have to write in a search where you search from your desktop in bottom of the starting. So there you have to write a cmd for command prompt and press enter. When you press there, you have to press enter, then this will come. Whatever your C drive, your username, whatever your name is mentioned there, it will visible there. And see, this is another example. You can, if you have given any directory your name, that will be visible there. Then what you have to do, cd, this whole path you have to write over there, cd app data, append data, local programs. These are a different directory Python. From python 32 script, you can write this in your command prompt. Otherwise, when you install a Python, then in a installation there is a path. I'll show you I'll give you recorded of that how to install a. So pip install numpy. Pip is a, before install you have to write pip library from Python library. You have to write a pip install numpy. Any software which you want to from a Python library, you need to write with the pip. Pip install numpy. further you have to use a pandas. Pandas also, how to use a install a pandas, pip install pandas also for data visualization. Pip install matplotlib, that is in your syllabus, I'll tell you later. So with the pip we have to install any from Python library, remember it. So this will help you to install a Python. With also, if you want to install a Jupyter notebook, then also pip install Jupyter notebook. You can write here instead of NumPy, Jupyter notebook. In Jupyter notebook, all function will work. Pandas, NumPy, everything will be pre-installed over there in a Jupyter notebook. Then you can install Jupyter notebook, everything. In the same time, you can do your code and there it will display the output also. So array are 1D or 2D. What is an array? Array are a homogeneous element and it is just like a list. It is just like a list, but it is different from a list. An array is a homogeneous element and list is a heterogeneous. See what is the difference between list and array. List and array. List means so here array are two types, 1D or 2D array. An array is a container. What is an array? It is a container which can hold fixed number of element here. Which can hold fixed number of element and these items should be of the same type. Same type means once you are declaring array as an int, it all the elements in an array will be integer type. Will be integer type. If you declare an array, that become a that same data type. If you are declaring a string, that become a string type. If you declare an integer, all the elements which you are assigning to array, that become a integer or same data type string. And here each element store in array, index is location of the element in an array has a numerical index. See here. So here array representation of array. Array can be declared in various ways in a different language given below. See here. Int array. Array is a variable name. Any variable name you can write here. You can decide here your variable name. Int is a data type. So here 5 is an element which you are storing in array. So equal is an assignment operator here. All the values, see, this is similar to list, but it is a different from a list. This you have to enclose in a curly bracket. So all values which are in an array index that starting with the 0th position. See here, 23 in a 0th position, 35 in a first position, 42 in a second position, 12 in a third position, 10 in a fourth position. So all the elements which are stored in array are beginning with the 0th position. See, this is a 1D, one dimension array. So all the elements in array can be right to left index. The positive index will be beginning with the left to right. It is in a 0, 1, 2, 3. If I am talking about the negative index, this become a minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. There are 4 elements in an array, but beginning with the 0 to 3 and ending with the negative index will be minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Last one element beginning with the minus 1. So it comes with the first element. So 2D array, see here, this is a one single value in an index. Here, row and columns. Rows and columns are here. This is called two row tree. See here, the two row, one, two rows and three columns. One, two, three columns. Two multiply by three here. Two multiply by three. This is called 2D array. Any number of row and column you can create here. So vertical and horizontal is called row. Vertical, that is called column. So here the components of array are axis are there. The dimension of array are described as its axis. Axis means that begin with the zero axis. Zero defines a 1D array. Which axis zero means it is a 1D array. Axis one means define a 2D array. Remember one thing, if axis become a zero, so that means it is a one dimensional array. Only row will be there, one, and single value number of elements located in that. And 2D array, that is a row and column. If it become a one, so that is a 2D array. So here shape of the ND array is a defined by the number of axes it process. So see the shapes here. Working with the NumPy. NumPy array are building blocks for a most NumPy operation. See 1D array. So 1D means this is a beginning with the any value with the zeroth position and that become a number of elements which you are assigning to the same variable will be assigned to all. See here. If num is a variable name, num0, num1, num2, num3, num4. So same variable will be shared in a different index. It is just like a list, but it is a different from a list. So list is a heterogeneous and array is a homogeneous. So that is the difference between list and array. So 1D array, see the elements here. And 2D array, multi-dimension and 2D array. See these rows and columns. This is a 1, 2, 3 row and 4 columns here. So it become a how to write a 0, 0. First row that become a 0, 0. Second row that become a 1. This is indicating this 0, 0. And this become a 0, 1. This become a 0, 2. This become a 0, 3. And here also 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2, 0, 3. And second line that become a this become a 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4. So this will 1, 3, 1. 1, 1 means first row. So it will be second. So it is second means 0, 1, 2. So all the elements can be stored in a column and rows. So here three rows and four columns. So it is known as a matrix. An array is a two-dimensional subscript. Index is a term as a two-dimensional array. See the difference between, if there is a question, what is the difference between NumPy and list? NumPy array and list. See the difference. NumPy array works on the homogeneous. Same data type will be shared in a different. In a list, it can be number, it can be float, it can be string. So Python lists are made up of a heterogeneous different type. And NumPy array does not support the additional and removal of elements. NumPy array does not support. It does not support and removal of elements. And Python lists support the additional and removal of elements. It is a mutable. Python list is a mutable and NumPy array is a immutable. So it can contain elements of the different data types. It can contain an element different type. Different type means it can be number, it can be float, it can be string, it can be boolean, So it has a different data type you can store in a list, but NumPy and array, only one type of value you can store in a array. See, you have declared as an integer, then integer value will be accept only. So less memory consumption in NumPy array, it will consume a less memory, it will consume a much more memory. And NumPy array, it is a faster in a runtime execution, and list runtime execution is a completely slower than the array. So this is a difference between NumPy and list. So here, how to create a NumPy and array? First, array name, this is not a keyword, it is a user defined name, any name, a, b, c, x, y, z, any name you can give with the bracket. So description, to create a NumPy array, we can simply pass Python list on array method. Only just you have to write a Python list. So here, example, this is a array name. Just you have to write a square bracket with the value separated with the comma. Value should be separated with the comma. And see here, same declaration of variable, values in a array, then array. So I am giving you example of this. I am sharing a Jupyter notebook. See here, import NumPy as np. What is import? Is a keyword, import, which I am importing, import math, import anything which you want to import from a Python library, you need to write a import. NumPy, which is a module I am importing here, as is a keyword. np means this is a user defined name, any name you can write here. I have written NumPy np for a NumPy short name. So here LST, any name you can give here, LST I have given. You can write a ABC XYZ, you can write a capital, any variable name here, 1, 2, 1, 3, 5, 7. I have assigned these value to array. A is a array name. So here array 1, this is also variable, I can write here A2. So np dot array, here I am writing here, which I have assigned a value in NumPy a, I have assigned to here. Now array 2, so I am writing here a2. So now I am running this program. See, simple you have to write. So Jupyter, this is the benefit of Jupyter notebook. Once you are writing code, where same you can get the output, run file. See here, these values are in a NumPy array, it will display. So import is a keyword here, NumPy is a module name, as is also keyword which you are using in a Python, Python also you are using in a MySQL or MySQL also. NP is a user defined name, A, B, C, X, Y, Z, any name you can give here. Because it is a NumPy, that's why I have given a short name of NP. So A is a array name, A, B, C, X, Y, Z, any variable name you can write, just like a list, you have to give the elements here. See here, I am using 10, 30, 50, 70. These are a different value. Now I am running this again. See. So whatever I am assigning value to array, these will be in the same index or same variable will be shared in a different. This will be first 10 element in a A0, 30 will be in a A1, and 50 will be in a A2, 70 will be in a A3. So A will be shared with the 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Four elements are there. 0, 1, 2, 3. Three times it will share with the index. So see here, this is an array. How to create an array? I have explained here. Now this is another which is given as a NumPy array data type. See, I am showing you data type, how to display a data type in array. See here, so I am using here import numpy as np. This is a importing a numpy as a np. Now type 1, this is a one variable which np dot array 1 2 3 4 5 6, these all values are stored in a type 1. Type 2, it is a decimal value I have stored here. And type 3, I have stored as a string character value. I have stored in a type 3. Type 4, string type value I have stored in a this. And type 5, these are a numeric or float, both I have stored here. See, now I am printing with the type, data type. I am printing all these. Which type of data it will be? So see here, first int, first one which is an integer, it is showing int 32, and second it is a decimal value, it is showing float, and third it is a character value, so it is a U5, and this is a float value which is a more data types is given, this showing float. So it is a string type, though it is showing a string only, which Canada and Australia is written, that is showing. So you can also show the data types here. So it is not a difficult, don't confuse what is NumPy. Just you have to write a variable type 1, type 2, type 3, type 4, type 5. These are our variables. You can write ABCD, any variable A to Z, you can write a variable here. So in this you can write a function. These are a function we can use in this. So array, first array function, that from string function is there. From in string function, what is the use of import numpy as a array? So data np as a from string. So from string you can print a data. And next one, empty. Empty is a function here. Empty is a function. Whatever empty value is there, it will display. See here, import numpy as np array. This is a another variable. This is a another variable, array equal np dot empty. Empty 3, 2 data type int print array. See what happens. I'm using this running in that Jupyter notebook. See, import numpy as a np array. This is a empty. Empty functions I am using here. I am running this. See. 2, 3. Here it is given empty 2 and 3. 2 and 3, it is given empty. So data type int. See here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These all value 3 rows, 2 columns. 3 rows, 2 column will be this 3 for row and 2 for column. This is a column and this is for row. 1 row, 2 row, 3 row. So 3 for rows and 2 for column here. So next is a zeros. How many zeros are there? You can view in a that. So here, same example I am running there. See, import. Import NumPy as a NP. Array is a variable name, np dot zeros. It will find 5 zeros, which is a data type int. Array 2 np zeros. This is a row and column, 2 row, 3 columns. Data type is a float. Third array third np zeros, 2. Only 2 rows is given, no column is there. It is a bool. When we print all 3 array 2, array 3, see what happens. See, first example, which is an array, np zeros 5. What happens? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 zeros are there. This line, see here, this line, 5 is written. 5 zeros will be printed in a first. Second, array 2, np zeros, 2, 3. 2, 3 means 2 row, 3 columns. See here, 2 rows, 3 column, 1, 2, 3. This will be for a second one. And third, this is for bool type, boolean, true and false. So it is given zeros 2. Row is given, but columns are not given. That's why both are a false. Row without value, it cannot be row and column. So 2, it is a empty. That's why it is showing false. So this is output of first. Line first ARR. This is output of array two, and this output of array 3. So empty zeros, this type of function you can revise. So next, ones. How many ones are there? This also we can use. I'm sharing another screen here. So I am writing instead of zeros, I am writing once here. Once. So first once, second zero. See the output here. Instead of zeros, here earlier it was written zeros. So 5 zeros was there. Now I have written once. So 5 times it is written a once. Here also I am writing a once. Once. So I am running this program. See here. First 5 ones. 5 times once will be print. Second 2 rows, 3 columns. So I am changing with the 5 rows, 3 column. See what happens. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 rows and 3 column. I am changing with the column 5. See what happens. 5 row, 5 columns. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rows and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 columns. So array is a very important topic. So it will help or in a data visualization. So do practice at home and download Jupyter Notebook so that at the same time you can get an output that can be downloaded from here, DOS prompt from your PC, bottom of the screen from where starting it, write a DOS. So enter there and pip install Jupyter Notebook, or otherwise you can download a NumPy, pip install NumPy. So once it's clear, now arrange. Arrange function is also there. Import NumPy as a NP. Array, this is a value. This 2 for a row, 7 for a column here. See here, 2 row, 7 column. So this is a another array 1, another variable NP. Arrange. So it will arrange a 1, 9, 3. See, I am also using this. So arrange, I am giving you example of this. See, same import NumPy as a NP. This is a variable. It's not, array is a variable name. I am writing A1. Don't confuse. A1. So here also I have to write A. Or A1. These are our variables. Here you have to write a function, array, arrange, ones, zeros. These are a function which you have to write here. Then run here. See what is here? 2 rows, 7 columns. 2, 7 means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 0 from 0. So here it is arranging with the, now it is a 7 column, but it is a 1, 9, 3. So in between, these values are not there. See, 1, 9, 3 will be arranged in a this way. So arrange function, arrange the value. Now we'll continue with the next function. Then line space is also there. It is also functions. How to do? Import NumPy as a NP. NumPy as a NP. This is importing. This is a array name NP dot line space 1, 10, 10. So see here, it will give the line space in that array 1, line space 1, 10, 2 in a second. And array 2. This is a line space 1, 10, 3. See here, this is a beginning with the 1 and ending with the 10, and 10 values are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. See here. And now second line, beginning with the 1, ending with the 10, only 2 elements are there. So 1 and 10 is there. Only 2 elements. This is for element. Third part, this is not an update, this is an element, how many elements you want to put in an array. So here